So when creating displays with PyVision, there's many different symbols as we've seen in the quick example before that we can do. So let's go through the different buttons and see what they do and how can we use them. So I'm still in my OSIsoft plant here. So I'll just go for one of the tank and we'll build a quick display. So if we look at the different symbols that we can use, the first one is the trend. So if I click on the trend symbol here, and then I can simply drag and drop any of the attributes, and this will build a trend. But within the trend, I can drag and drop another attribute, and then we'll add it on the same display. If I add it next to the trend on a different one, it will create a brand new trend. The second symbol that we have is the value symbol. So the value symbol here allows me to just show the value as the name indicates here. So I can have the value and maybe I want to also change what it's showing. Then I can quickly right click and this allows me to open more options for any of them. So in this case, I'll only be showing the value and the label. The next one is the table. So the table allows us to have multiple attributes together. So maybe I want to look at the pressure, the percentage full, the level, and the internal temperature. So here I'm just holding the control key, and this allows me to multi-select all my attributes. And one more time, we simply drag and drop. So this created a quick table here. So one more time, I could right-click, and I can configure what columns do I want to see, which one do I not want to see, and maybe I want to change the sorting order or anything like that. So once you have the table, you can really configure it the way you want. The next symbols are the two vertical and horizontal gauges. So maybe I'm interested in looking at the pressure. So one more time, I simply select the symbol, and then I can drag and drop my attribute. So here I have my pressure and a gauge. I could be doing the same thing for the horizontal, exactly the same idea here. Same applies for the radial gauge. We look at the result that it gives. So I can get a gauge, and here I could also change maybe the minimum and the maximum of the gauge. And I could also turn it into a multi-state where it will change color where there's a certain value. So those are all concepts that we will go into as we start working on the exercises. The last one here is the asset comparison table. So the asset comparison table allows us to compare different assets. So here maybe I'm interested in looking at the pressure, the internal, the external temperature, and the flow rate. So those are, let's say, my KPIs. So here I have them for mixing tank one. Well, it's called the asset comparison table. This means it's meant to compare different assets. So what I can do is I can simply drag and drop the element. So note that I'm not in the attribute here. I am in the element pane. I will drag and drop it into the table. And here I can compare the same attributes for a number of elements. So let's browse through the hierarchy and let's go under line two. And we can do the same thing. So now I have an asset comparison table comparing four different assets. I have a value symbol, a trend symbol, multiple gauges, and a table. So those are all symbols that I can find right here. There's also the possibility of adding more symbols. If you're interested in doing that, or maybe even building your own symbol, then you can just visit our PyScore community and you can have all the details. You can also refer to your workbook for any of the symbols, have a little bit more information on them. But as we go through the demos and the exercises, we'll be using all of them. We also have the ability to look at event frames here, which we will go into details a little bit later. We also have the graphic library, which allows you to add some graphics to your display. We have all the standard buttons here, so undo, redo. We can have cut, copy, paste. You can also do it with the keyboard. So I can multi-select. And maybe I just want to hit the delete button, and that will delete my symbols here. And I could undo, I could redo. I'm also able to add a few different shapes here. So this is really going to be, as you build the displays, you'll be using all of them. I can also add some text. So one more time, when we actually start doing more exercises, you'll be able to get more familiar with all those functions. So now, let's say I'm satisfied with my display. I can simply save it, give it a meaningful name. And I've now saved my display, and I can simply share the URL with any one of my colleagues, and now they can access the display. They can also move the time bar here, so you can look for 8 hours, 1 day, or I can also manually enter the time range that I want. I can go back in time. I can go forward in time. So this is, right now I'm simply visualizing this display. So this could be one of your colleagues whom you share data with. We can also note that by using the power of templates in AF, we can also navigate through different assets. So we've only built one display, but we in fact have a display for each of our tanks. So in the case of having 4 tanks, I basically have 4 displays. But what if you had an asset with 100 assets that are all in the same templates? Well, then you could go through all of them. So as we've looked a little bit on how the different buttons work, I'll invite you to just do the next exercise, and this will allow you to just touch and use all the buttons, and you'll be able to see what they do. And don't be afraid, there's nothing you can break, so just click on everything and try to make it work, and then we'll go through the different questions together.